Hey folks, Matt from ArtOfTheImage.com. The M50, which I have in here for review, as you know, and I'm really liking this little guy. It's got the 55 to 200 on it right now, if you're wondering what lens that is. And the M50 has rocked the boat. It's changed things up, and it will impact everything Canon does from this point on, because a lot of the tech in here moves the bar up. So you're going to have to see that or better at all the higher price points. Which begs the question, we've discussed the 7D3 a little bit lately. Even to the point of, I think the last video, we discussed 90D 7D3 consolidation. One of our viewers was bringing up the point that, will we see two different cameras, a 90D and a 7D Mark III? Or will Canon consolidate the lineup into one? Will we no longer have that? Will we have just like a super enhanced 90D? Or will they eliminate the 90D, that level altogether, and just have a 7D3? Interestingly enough, since that video, I forget which site, might have been Canon Rumors, I can't remember. Somebody was pointing out that there was rumors or talk that there was going to be a camera even in between those levels. So rather than consolidate, there was going to be a 90D, something above it, and then the 7D3. So they were going to add a camera to the lineup. I don't know what to think of that. Not sure I buy that. But I've been going over specs of the 7D Mark II and thinking about what the 7D3 has to be in order to be competitive in light of what we get in the M50 and the other advancements in other cameras. I mean, the 7D Mark II is getting a little old in the tooth. So what should we expect out of the 7D3 if we get it? If there's going to be a 7D3, what can we expect? What specs can we expect? Let's bear in mind that the 7D Mark II is a 20 megapixel sensor. It has dual pixel AF, albeit at this point an older version of it, just because the camera's getting dated. 10 frames per second continuous shooting with autofocus. Now that's still fairly impressive, especially for a DSLR. 65 all cross-type autofocus sensor points. 150,000 RGB plus 1R pixel metering sensor. 1R, plus IR pixel metering sensor. So basically an advanced color metering system. Dual Digic 6 processors, enhanced environmental sealing, compact flash and SD slots, USB 3, built-in GPS, larger capacity LPE6N battery, 1/8,000th of a second shutter speed max, and the shutter rated to 200,000 cycles. So, and a lot of these are pro-level specs in the sense that if you compare this to the 80D, the difference is we certainly don't have the shutter speeds. We don't have the shutter, the cycles, the rated number of cycles. In other words, as durable a shutter. We don't have the full weather sealing. We have a 7,560 pixel RGB plus IR metering system versus the 150. We've got 45 point AF system versus the 65. So there's a lot in here that's at a higher level than the Canon 80D. Now, I have made the point before that I think the 80D is more than enough value, and especially if I was buying between these two today, I would go 80D, even with some of the advances that the 7D Mark II still has. But looking at that, the 80D also has a 24 megapixel sensor, so it's got a more advanced, more higher megapixel, higher resolution sensor. We've also got a fully articulated touchscreen, and some people argue that the basically up till now we've seen the higher pro level cameras not have that. I say it's time to end that. It's totally an advantage. Once you've been shooting with one, you don't want to give one up. They can certainly build one, as they are in some of the other higher level cameras. Usually they're doing flip-ups, but they need to go full articulating touchscreen, just like what's in the 80D. Put it on a 7D Mark III. Let's stop crippling our higher-level cameras. And, oh, the other thing I didn't mention was I did mention the 7D Mark II had 10 frames per second. The 80D has 7 frames per second. Now, if we factor in this guy, the M50, we start to see even more of where the 7D3 needs to be at, because we've got the 24 megapixel sensor, so again, better than the 7D Mark II. So we need at least that 24 megapixel sensor. We've got a 2.36 million dot OLED EVF. What I'd like to see in a 7D Mark III is an OLD EVF / OVF, a hybrid. You get both. There's Fujis that do that. And we need the variangle LCD, again, and 4K video. So now we're starting to see some of the things that we need from the 80D and the M50, plus some stuff. We still got to have more. So the specs we need in a 7D Mark III are at least a 24 megapixel sensor. I would suggest going to a 30, because if this is going to be our flagship APS-C from Canon, let's differentiate it from the other ones with a little bit of extra resolution. 30 megapixels should be no problem at current technology to give us a 30 megapixel sensor that performs as well as the 24 megapixel sensor. And that would differentiate the flagship. Maybe it would perform even better, even at 30 megapixels. I think they could do that too. The frames per second needs to stay at least the same, but I think higher would be a possibility. I think they could probably do it. And I think, again, move the specs forward. We've got the 65 all cross-type autofocus sensor, and we got the 150,000 RGB metering. I suspect we see a more advanced system in both. Doesn't need to be, but I suspect we will. Usually we see some advancements in both autofocus and metering. We've got dual Digic 6 processors. Well, the M50 has introduced us to Digic 8, so I think we can respectively see dual Digic 8 processors. I think it's a good chance that's what we would get. I'd be surprised if we didn't. We would want to maintain, if not improve, the enhanced environmental sealing, although I'm not really saying there was an issue with the 7D Mark IIs, but you want to maintain that. Maybe, take it up a little bit just for advertising and kudos reasons, to push it, to promote it. Always better to make things better. The dual card slots. We need to get rid of compact flash. It's a dinosaur. So we're going to see dual SDs, probably UHS 2s. I can't imagine they'd just go UHS 1s. So dual SD card slots, which will be a welcome improvement on the 7D Mark III. We're going to maintain the USB 3, the built-in GPS, the larger capacity batteries. That's always going to be an advantage of that higher pro-level DSLR, especially the battery. That's a good differentiating advantage. Bigger, heavier DSLR, but the battery's bigger, so it accommodates that and gives us better battery life. We're going to add 4K, and if Canon's smart about this, that's how they're going to differentiate this flagship APS-C body too. We're going to see 4K with no crop other than just the sensor crop, the 1.6 times APS-C crop. In other words, full readout, no binning, straight from the sensor. Something like the A6500 does. More than possible, and in a flagship body, they can do that. They can give that to us because there's no technical reason not to do it. And with the flagship APS-C body, there's no financial reason not to do it either, because you're at the top of the heap for their APS-C bodies. You're not into full frame, so give us everything, because you're still not giving us full frame in the sense that there's your differentiating factor. This can be a better 4K camera than a 6D Mark III when it comes out, because the 6D Mark III is the low-end full frame. The top-end APS-C can have all the tech thrown in because it's still an APS-C sensor. It's not going to threaten your full-frame bodies. We want the variangle touchscreen LCD. Give us the one out of the 80D or the M50 or even better, but we need that. It's time. Let's do it. And as I said, an EVF. And I suggest, at least in this iteration of the DSLRs, as we're still pumping out DSLRs, EVF, OVF. Offer us both. You're going to satisfy the people that don't like EVFs yet, although for those of you that, if you've used them, you're probably like me, you're a convert. If you haven't, you should try them. And if you give us an EVF, OVF, who's to object? So this is how I think the 7D Mark III needs to be spec'd to be competitive, relevant, and a good seller. To knock it out of the park, to make existing 7D users happy, it'll be a great update to the 7D Mark II. What do you guys think though? Do you agree with the specs of the 7D Mark III as I'm speccing it out here, the things I think it needs, what it should have in it? Am I missing something? Did I leave something out that you think is important? Is there something I've included that you don't think is important? Again, always better to have more than less though, so be interesting to hear what you have to say. Let me hear what you guys have to say in the comments below. 7D Mark III, what do you think? How should it be spec'd? Have I missed something? Is there something you don't think we need in here? And I guess we might as well throw in, you know, are we going to still see one? But we've already talked about that. Let's just talk about how we're speccing it. Really interested to hear what you guys have to say. Thanks for tuning in. Stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at artoftheimage.com.